6:44. It is 104.3 MyFM. It's Valentine's morning. So no, it's Dan Reynolds going to be on the show after 8 o'clock this morning. Kevy's off today. But Dan Reynolds on the show with us doing a Zoom session. We'll have him after 8 o'clock, new music, and he's going to talk about the album and stuff and everything in his life and his abs. Yeah. He got ripped a few years back, man.
Yeah, he did.
Lisa Fox was all excited. She wanted to be part of the Zoom session. She was sending out an email last night. Lisa does her midday show here at MyFM. She's sending out an email like, can I be on the Zoom session? I won't turn my camera on. Like, Lisa, he's not going to do a take off your shirt show or something, you know?
You never know.
No, he's not. He's not going to do that on Zoom. He's not going to do it. Besides, Lisa, you've got Chef Eric, your boyfriend.
That's right.
Oh, yes.
Be true to him. So this is one of those stories that, it'll make it quick here, because, you know, sometimes people don't care about stuff like this. But this is probably similar to something you've gone through in your life when you had 2 or 3 days in a row where just everything seems to be going wrong, right?
When it rains, it pours.
When it rains, it pours. And I could have used the rain for the fire in Santa Clarita.
Yeah.
So we get evacuated from the house the other night, you know, and the fire's raging up there. And the firefighters just did a fantastic job. All the services around that, fighting the fire, did a great job. The city, everybody did great. So that's like 50%+ contained. They did fine with it. So it's just raging. We're getting evacuated. We're all scared. The neighborhood's scared. It's a very emotional thing to be evacuated from your home, regardless if you have any, you know, background in that stuff or not. It's still quite a scary thing because you're worried about your family, your home, your property, everything. So we're getting evacuated, and we're evacuated out. And then my wife sends me back to get my son's cleats. So I've got to go back to the sheriff's deputy and go, I'm just going to run back to grab my son's cleats. You know, and all right, whatever. And the turf cleats too, apparently. Okay, fine, you weirdo, go ahead. So that's how my whole week was kind of going midweek, right? And so then yesterday I got to go to my dermatologist, and I do that every 6 months. You guys should do that too. Dermatologist is important if you live in Southern California. And she's the best, she's probably the premier dermatologist in Southern California, works out of UCLA.
Nice.
She's great, absolutely love this lady. So I go to her, and she checks everywhere. She's the one that you got to drop your pants, because even if the sun doesn't hit it, it doesn't mean that cancer can't. So if your dermatologist doesn't check everywhere, you might need a new dermatologist. That's what I learned.
Okay.
So she's checking all that stuff. She finds a mole on my back, and she's removed moles before. She goes, yeah, we're going to have to cut this out. I'm like, okay, all right, this is going to be fun. It really didn't feel a thing, but she cut a big chunk out of my back, right? So fine, they'll test it for cancer and all that stuff. So on the way over to UCLA after the show yesterday, my car, my Toyota Prius, felt just a little off. And it's a great car, and I love this ride so much that I can tell when something's a bit off. But I'm like, I gotta get there. So I'm just tooling along the freeways, cutting over the canyons. Waze is taking me through the really rich people's neighborhoods.
Oh.
They're so mad. They're so mad. I'm seeing houses like, oh my God, this house is gorgeous. I have to mark this on a map and look at it from above and be nosy. Just beautiful homes, and the people hate that. They absolutely hate it. You see them coming out there, putting their trash cans in the middle of the street just to make you go around them so you won't come there again or something. They're going on Waze and reporting cops all up and down the street just to keep people off that street. That's what they do. So anyway, beautiful homes. So the car just didn't feel right, didn't know what it was. Go in, get my little minor surgery, come back out in the parking garage at UCLA. I'm on like Bravo 1. So I'm down below, 610 clearance, tough for a tow truck because I got a flat tire. Not a little flat tire, big old flat tire, right? Like, oh, bummer, man, bummer. And I've got really no cell service, so I can't call AAA. So I hit the SOS button on the Toyota. Boom! All of a sudden, I'm connected to a lady willing to help me out. Great connection, too. So I don't know what they got in there, but it didn't matter that I was having a problem with cell service down below. So she's like, yeah, we'll send a tow, and we'll send somebody out there that can take care of you and stuff. We'll get you out of there. And give me the clearance and stuff. We'll send a smaller tow, no worries. So I waited for a band, maybe half an hour, not that bad. Guy calls up, and this is the tow company now, not Toyota. Whoever they contracted with, maybe, or something. And he calls up, and he's like, hey, what's going on? What's going on with you? You got a car problem? Yeah, I got a flat tire. So what's happening? I got a flat tire. It's flat. All right. I'll be in a few minutes. So a really weird experience. Great guy in the end, but funny experience.
Yeah.
So he gets there, calls him back. All right, I'm outside. Where are you at? Same place, haven't moved. I'm still in the parking garage on B1 in row D. You know, I've told everybody that. All right, can you drive it out? No, I got a flat tire. What part of this conversation are we missing here? I have a flat tire, like super flat. Not like baby flat, sir. Like really super flat. Like it's so flat, it's like the flat earthers are calling it their inspiration. You know, it's that flat, okay?
Okay.
So he goes, all right, but it's a run flat. What do you mean it's a run flat? It's not running at all, it's flat. No, all these new cars have run flats. You can drive it out. I don't think I can drive it out. I mean, when I'm telling you it's flat, it's like really, really flat. It's on the ground flat. He's, just drive it out. You'll be fine. All right, fine. So I start driving out. I drive really slow, and I'm going through. I'm telling a story here about getting out of UCLA with my flat tire yesterday. And I'm going up the parking garage ramp, and at that hospital, it's like a circular ramp and everything. It's kind of a crazy little setup. And everybody behind me is cursing. Come on, what's wrong with you? They don't know I have a flat tire. Nice. They just think I'm a guy that wants to drive at 3 miles per hour outside, through the parking gates, all that stuff. So long story short, I get up to the top, right? I get there, and I go, okay, I'm up top, where are you at? I'm outside. Well, I'm outside, where are you? I'm outside the hospital. Which side of the hospital?
Oh, no.
It's on the wrong side of the hospital. It takes him 10 minutes to get over there. Comes up in his truck, and he looks at the flat tire. I'm over on the side of the driveway at UCLA, and he goes, yeah, it's flat. Yeah, what do you mean? I told you it was flat. There's no doubt in the flat. So then he gives me, you got a spare in there? Again, no, there's no spare. Sorry, just no spare. Because you got a compressor in the back of that Toyota? Do I have a what? Do I have a compressor in the back? Yeah, an air compressor to fill it up. No, I left my toolbox at home to fill up people's tires, and so I must have left my compressor at home. I'm sitting there going, what are you talking about? Why would I have an air compressor? Who drives around, maybe some people do, with an air compressor in the back of the car, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. He goes, no, sometimes these cars come with air compressors. No, sir, there's no air compressor. I'm in the back of my car all the time. My kid's soccer gear, look, there's nothing there. He opens some compartment, pulls out an air compressor.
In my face,
this guy. Pulls out an air compressor and some white liquid. He goes, what you do, you put this on the air compressor, hook this up to your tire, fills it up with white liquid, seals the hole, and you're all set, good to go.
Who knew?
Well, you went from dumb to brilliant in about 2 seconds. So yeah, the guy fills up my tire, fills it up with stuff, and he goes, you can take that tire to get a new tire from Walmart, but it's all sealed up and stuff. Who knew?
Yeah, right.
Who knew?
I wonder if I've got something like that in my
RAV4. I'm sure you do. It was hidden off to the side, but check for it.
Wow.
Way to go, Toyota. Yeah, I was blown away by that, you know?
Yeah.
And then I was, but what a day. Oh my God, from the skin cancer to the fires to the flat tires to all that stuff. Then I get home and they go, what's for dinner? What's for dinner?
Hey. 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 H
saying, apparently more people than I thought now have compressors in the back of their car, so apparently it wasn't a dippy question the guy had asked me. And I did have a compressor, but didn't even know.
But who knew? That's the thing. Who knew you had it back then?
Who knew is right, Jill. It's a pink type of day. I got you. Dan